would be the alternate, like, fill in the hole and come back and find them?
You know, stop, prompt whatever they're doing, and they would have to, but, you know, while we're moving, I think we take advantage of this, you know, rather than stop them, like, we get this project done, just, you know, effectively a year early.
Chairman?
Councilman?
Okay, so this is for, just so people don't know, this is for the sewer lining, right?
Yes, ma'am.
And the sewer lining and the, what else is it?
This is essentially what they, we've identified sewers that need lining because they're degrading from our SAW grant back in 2013. So we decided which sewers we can tackle with the monetary money that we have available to us. So we'll go out there and they clean them and they line them, which gives them more strength, it strengthens their support and adds 20 or 30 years to their design life.
He does some interesting things. Chairman?
Yes. Councilman, I'm sorry, I was just looking at the detail on the bids and the.
So, so this spring sometime, could you let me know where they're at? When they start a bigger project, I'd like to come and witness it.
Right now, they have finished doing the prep, which is the cleaning portion and the televised portion. They're working in section seven of the city, which is basically north of E-Course and west of Pelham. They should be lining here in the next couple of weeks, but I can definitely alert the administration and yourself when they start the lining process.
I'd like to see that.
And this one, just looking at the detail, right, this went out, took bid last August. There were two bids received and what was the low budgeted amount?
For what it's worth, we put out the bid, got one bidder, and then the administration wanted to make sure we tried to be as competitive as possible, so we rebid it and we got a second bidder, which turned out to be less.
Okay.
Chairman?
Councilman?
Is that the oldest part, is that the oldest lines that you're doing, or the sewers?
I'd be speculating if I answered that. I'm not.
I think it is, right, it's west of Pelham and.
It's that Pinecrest sub that we're in now.
Oh, okay, I think the oldest is Van Born.
Yeah, or maybe they did that earlier.
They already did that, okay. Is that how you're doing them? Is it ordered by age or just?
No, so when we did the SAW grant, we televised almost all the infrastructure, sanitary sewer infrastructure in the city of Taylor, and they were all given a rating to determine how good or how bad, kind of like the PASER rating works. So we could do $10 million of sewer lining based on the SAW grant, but we don't have the fiscal funds. So we try to take the worst case scenario ones and tackle them as we move forward. That seems to be the most responsible way to approach it.
Any further questions? Item 7.10, a motion by Councilwoman Witt, supported by Councilman Johnson. All those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. The yeses have it, motion carried. Item 7.11, motion to amend City Council Resolution Number 9.426-22 to remove the $75,000 per fiscal year budget limit restriction funded through Sewage Disposal System Fund.
Make that motion.
Support.
By Councilman Johnson, supported by Councilwoman Grandana. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. The yeses have it, motion carried. Item 7.12 is a motion to approve Bidigar Contractors Incorporated lowest qualified bidder for the 2022 Water Main Improvements Contract Base Bid. $1,453,875, alternate one, $790,385, and Beach Daily Wick Road intersection water main extensions, $266,500, plus a 10% contingency of $251,076, for an amount not to exceed $2,761,836, funded through Water Supply System Fund.
Make that motion.
Motion by Councilman Johnson, supported by Councilwoman Rose. Is there any discussion?
Through the chair. Chris, do you want to come up and explain?
I was just going to go right ahead. I was going to read off some of the notes, but go right ahead. Well, let me help you out here. The proposed water main improvements are being selected in an effort to realign our water main infrastructure assets by updating portions that have exceeded their design life, improve system deficiencies, and attempt to minimize interruptions of service to our city of Taylor residents and businesses.
determined during the design phase that there's no easements on the north side of Wick Road from Wilkie to Beach Hill. So we're trying to secure those easements now. We spoke to all nine of them. We're trying to get those in place before this project goes out. I know there has been preliminary discussions about possibly council and the administration want to resurface Beach Hill from Van Born to Wick. So when I looked at the unit prices and they determined them to be favorable, I think now would be the time to cross Beach Daily Road to the west and then cross Wick Road to the south to have new utilities before we bring new pavement on top. That's where the addition is coming from.
Okay, so
this project would go from, Telegraph to the west side of Beach Daily.
Okay, so with that being said, when you go south on Beach Daily, you're going to be connected to the water mains there that feed all those houses?
Yes, sir. So when we cross to the south at Beach Daily Wick, we're only going to go to the edge of pavement, plus or minus 80, 90, 100 feet, and tap into the existing infrastructure. That's it.
So if you go west on Wick Road, are you going to go as far as Beach Daily? Or as far as Holland or as far as Inkster?
No, sir. We're only going to go 80 feet to get past the influence of the road for Beach Daily, and then a future project would be picking it up from there and moving on, so we never have to go back and tear up the pavement.
Okay, thank you.
The chair, Chris, what is that? I know we're increasing the size of the pipe as well, right?
Yes, sir. The master plan determined that to improve the overall water flows in the city of Taylor, it was recommended that the existing 8-inch water main on Wick Road from Allen to Inkster is currently 8-inch. This part of this project will make that 8 to a 12, which will improve water quality, and future endeavors in the city will increase the rest of Wick Road from 8-inch to 12-inch.
Mr. Mayor, I know we've talked about that area, particularly that park.
I heard it told.
Yeah,
well, through the chair, yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, so is this infrastructure on the north side or is it on the south side?
Well,
is it on Pat Park?
We're looking at doing the complete road, so we will definitely, I think Guido, we literally just talked about this the other day and had a feeling that it would be brought up.
And just to be
clear, I agree, but we would have to do some leveling there too, so we have to.
Well, either leveling or a separation where it's, you know, one way in, one way out. The issue with that we've raised in the past is people backing out.
And that's
from. I'm sorry.
I don't mean to cut you off, but that's a good point. We could maybe, you know, an entrance in, you know, one way in, one way out type situation. That way, they're still not backing out in the Wick Road.
Yeah, have a guardrail along there. The concern has been, right, those are the littlest kids that play at those two fields, both T-ball and farms, and they tend to run out behind the cars, and the cars that are backing up, it's just been very difficult. And fundamentally, Wick Road is an old country road, and I think it's the last one that we, you know, truly, east-west road that we haven't truly regraded, but given where the houses are at, I'm not certain how far down you take it. So anyway, it's all part of it. You do be what's underground, but you want to plan for what we're planning on doing above ground.
Through the chair, that is going to be probably part of the design scope in the new road.
Any further discussions? Hearing none, we have a motion by Councilman Johnson, supported by Councilman Rose. All those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed, say no. The yeses have it. Motion carried. Item 7.13 is a motion to approve Wade Trim & Associates, current vendor, to perform the construction, administration, construction, engineering, construction, inspection, CEI, services for $246,600 and design services contract addition cost of $29,900 for the 2022 water main improvements construction contract for a total amount not to exceed $276,500. Funded through Water Supply System Fund.
Motion to approve.
Support.
Motion by Councilman Brandao, supported by Councilman Johnson. Hearing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. The yeses have it. Motion carried. Item 7.14 is a motion to approve the mayor and city clerk to sign an intergovernmental agreement between the City of Ramos, the City of Taylor, and UniFirst Corporation for sanitary sewer services at 9951 Inkster Road, Taylor, Michigan, 4818.